Hi, I haven't done a video for a long while, so I hope this will be the beginning of a new beginning. I would like to discuss two issues with you today. Number one, climate change. Number two, the rise of China. How these two events will have impact on our lives in the next few decades. For climate change, understand that there are still people denying the existence of a man-made climate change. This is very unfortunate. For example, the second largest polluter, the United States, their president withdraw from the Paris Accord, which is shameful. We all understand that as temperature rises, the earth getting warmer, more moisture is evaporated from the rivers, the ponds, the sea, the lakes, etc. So there are more moisture in the atmosphere. As this moisture meets cool air, inevitably there will be cool air, then they will condense from water vapor into water and eventually fall back to earth. That means we should be expecting higher rainfall, and when rain fails, it will be heavier than before, which is true at the moment. And we also expect to see higher snowfall as well, because as this higher moisture content being condensed and fall down on Earth as snow, they are much heavier than before. So any denier saying that, hey, look at the snowfall, this is heavy snowfall, why don't we say it is global warming? Yes, that is exactly why you have heavier snowfall, because there are more moisture in the air. At the same time as this water vapor condenses back to water, it releases latent heat. This latent heat drives the atmospheric events such as storms, hurricanes, typhoons, and so forth. So in the recent years, we see there are much more stronger. For example, in the United States, the type 4-5 hurricanes are much more frequent than before. Again, this is the consequence of global warming. So global warming will have a very huge impact onto our lives. The natural disasters such as weather conditions becomes much more severe. At the moment, California is burning. Again, why? Because on one hand, yes, the atmospheric moisture is increased, but at the same time, the higher temperature also makes the earth much more dry. The land is drier, and therefore forest fire will be much more severe and more frequent. So that is the consequence. What we do? Well, we need to at least start to reduce our carbon emissions. But unfortunately, that is just noise. Nobody's actually doing much except probably China. So I will be talking about that in another video later. At the same time, China rises. Now, China rises unlike, for example, the rise of Japan, which has a much smaller population. China is huge. Huge in terms of land. China is arguably either the third or the fourth largest country in the world. The largest, of course, is Russia. The second one is Canada. The third and fourth is United States or China. So it has a very large amount of land. The secondly, China is also the most populous country in the world. Yes, a lot of people. 1.4 billion people. So there's a lot of people. Another, compare with India, for example, all Chinese have a common language. Yes, we speak a different dialects, but the written language is the same throughout China. That means information or knowledge published in Chinese can be read by 1.3 to 1.4 billion people, depending on the literacy weight of the country. Probably I will argue at around 90-something%. So over a billion people is able to access the same common knowledge base. This is the largest brain power anywhere on Earth. Secondly, China's best students are taking hard science subjects like science, technology, engineering, medicine, and so forth. Whereas, for example, in the West, America in particular, the brightest students take the soft courses like law, commerce. So in terms of innovation, in terms of creativity, China is going to release a creativity explosion we never see before. China is catching up. At the same time, because of the political environment, a lot of technology which China wants has been limited. So the Western world tried to inhibit export of technology to China. So what China can do? Well, they have to do it by themselves. Examples are, for example, the supercomputers. Just a couple of years ago, China's supercomputers depends on imported ICs, typically from Intel. But in the last months of Obama administration, they banned the sale of some Intel chips to the supercomputer producer in China. So what China do? They develop their own chips. So that is what is happening at the moment. As China continues to rise, it has the ability to innovate in every dimension that we want to compete with. It can innovate in manufacturing, it can innovate in electronics, it can innovate in artificial intelligence, and so forth. Every domain, if China determined to put their effort together in that domain, then China will dominate. Now, with a large domestic market, as well as the brain pool, the most number of people speaking the same language, the largest brain pool in the world. The only consequence is that all this domain which China want to innovate will dominate. So what is the rest of the world can do? What Australia can do in that situation? If we try to compete with China, we lose. Definitely. Because we don't have that manpower, we don't have that determination, we don't have the edge. So at the moment, the world needs to start asking a question. What is my country's competitive advantage, which I can continuously protect? For example, in Australia here, what can we do? You want to compete with medicine? Come on, we got less people than Shanghai. Our population is less than the population of Shanghai. How can we compete? No way. So we have to start a national conversation, and that is not limited to Australia. Actually, it applies to everywhere in the world. Because as I just mentioned, if China wants to, it can dominate every aspect of human creativity. So what can we do? I will argue that every nation on Earth have a decision to make. That decision is, how can we protect the competitive advantage of that particular nation in order to survive in the global village which will be dominated by China? Now, we also understand that China, unlike the West, is not going to invade any other country. It will use its trading power, economic power to get what it wants. Well, it's actually much better than using bombs, isn't it? But at the same time, we in the world have to think, well, what can we do? How can we survive in a situation where China is dominating, at least economically? So for Australia, we are going to have a local election in one of the districts in Sydney. One of the problem now arising is our Prime Minister, Malcolm Turnbull, has been talking about the Chinese interference in our political system. I think he is bullshitting. China doesn't want to interfere anybody's political system. China only want to do business. But at the same time, if you accept donations, why not? If I can influence you through money, I will. That's to fact of life. And honestly, the Liberal Party receives as much, if not more, donations from Chinese businessmen in their political campaign. So what to complain? The issue here is China is a factor. It's a factor of about our own survival, and we have to discuss this. We have to discuss how Australia can survive given we have a rising power, which is China. Well, at the moment, we survive by selling primary resources to China, like gas, like iron ore, and so forth. But we know that China and Russia have a long-term energy agreement. They are building oil pipes, gas pipes, directly from Russia. It costs less than shipment from Australia. Then eventually we will be outcompeted by Russia. What can we do? This is a discussion every nation have to have with its own citizen. Look at the competitive advantage the country has in light of a dominating economically powerful China. What can we do? I'm not going to give you the answer today because this is a long process. I hope everybody can start thinking about that questions, and I will be throwing in my ideas as well later on. Anyway, glad to be back, and hope that you like this first video. I'm going to make more in the near future. Okay, thank you.